Welcome back to my stand-up channel. Ryan Laundrie's parents may have told cops where to find their son in exchange for immunity, his close friend has speculated. Laundrie's longtime pal told The Sun exclusively that they believe Ryan's parents made a deal with the district attorney for immunity. The tipster, who wishes to remain anonymous, revealed the information came from someone who knows Laundrie's family and is a close friend of the pair. They said, "We believe his mom and dad struck some sort of secret deal of immunity between either the Florida DAR or the FBI. Obviously, they want to save themselves and every little bit they have left." The friend said that the agreement most likely would require the parents to provide the necessary evidence to close the case and help investigators find their son in exchange for immunity for all charges of harboring, assisting, or whatever it might be. The friend said that Laundrie's notebook could contain clues to solve Petito's death, whom a medical coroner determined had died due to strangulation. "I think this is the outcome we expected," the friend told The Sun after Laundrie's remains were found and subsequently identified. "I don't know if it's the one we would ask for," the friend made a deal. The revelation comes after web sleuths have similarly speculated Laundrie's parents made a deal with the FBI to reveal what they know about where the location of his body might be on the condition they were free from prosecution. In a TV interview, the lawyer for Laundrie's family said conversations were had with respect to certain charges, insisted no deal was cut after claims were put to him. But internet detectives believe there were clearly negotiations that they claim led to Laundrie's parents telling authorities information related to where their son's body was, in exchange for immunity from being prosecuted. Partial remains. After an almost five-week manhunt, cops last week found partial remains in the Carlton Reserve, Sarasota. They positively identified the skull and bones as belonging to Laundrie, 23, through his dental records. Read our Brian Laundrie live blog for the very latest news and updates. A cause of death has not been released as the remains were sent to an anthropologist. Ever since Gabby was reported missing and later found dead, internet sleuths have also trawled through Laundrie's social media. Laundrie was last seen alive on September 13 after telling his parents, Chris and Roberta, that he was going hiking in the Carlton Reserve in Sarasota County, Florida, but failed to return home. Cops found a notebook while Chris Laundrie unearthed a dry bag. Illegal resources to escape. Laundrie's longtime friend exclusively told The Sun that Laundrie had plans of living outside the U.S. since high school and revealed the countries he may escape to. He added that from a young age, Laundrie has been a good planner and can execute his plans in exactly the way he wants. "I think he'd be able to put the resources together to get out of the country, either illegally or under some sort of a fake identification," the friend told The Sun. "He's the type of person that would be able to drop everything to secure his means of not being captured and to evade arrest or evade prosecution from what seems to be a pending crime." The friend described Laundrie as a heavier-set social outcast when he was younger who always had a fascination for art, specifically drawing, and enjoyed science fiction movies. He added that Brian was an intelligent and independent student who tended to keep to himself. Brain's favorite film director is Neil Blomkamp, who created Chappie, Elysium and District 9. Blomkamp is from South Africa, the friend said. That's a country that Brian was talking about a lot because that was one of his favorite genres of movies. Two of those three movies took place in South Africa. Upon learning about Laundrie's disappearance, the friend reached out to some of the other friends in the group and was reminded the fugitive spoke highly of New Zealand. One of his favorite movies was always Lord of the Rings, which all the filming occurred in New Zealand and it is a very beautiful country, the friend said. So I'm sure if he had the time and the resources in a few years and he really needed to get away from this issue, that's probably somewhere he would end up. Source: nypost.com. Please like, share and subscribe. Thank you for watching.